Well, don't be alarmed. It's not New Zealand Comedy Festival time of year again so soon. However, due to its massive success at this year's festival, the best comedy show on earth, and that's the way we always have to say it,
yes,
too,
it
the
is,
best
it
comedy show on earth is now heading on a national tour. To tell us more, please welcome two of the stars, Melanie Bracewell and Eli Matthewson.
Yes. Thank you.
Welcome, welcome. I'm nice to see you again. So the tour, you're getting the band back together.
Absolutely. Touring the North and South Island just to get amongst the people, New Zealand.
Yeah. It's like a band touring, but we only ever are on stage by ourselves, so we don't talk backstage.
It would be like if a band was touring, but then the drummer came out and did a solo, and then the singer came out, and then they did a guitar, and then none of them really.
At the end, you've got to put it all together yourself. You manage the tracks. It would sound like if you mix it all as one.
Yeah.
Well, no, this is good sight because obviously you went down a treat at the comedy festival. So how does it work? Is it kind of like a pick and mix? Is it, you know, for those people that have commitment issues with comedians, you just come along and you see six different acts?
Yeah, especially because the Comedy Festival sort of kind of favours Auckland and Wellington, so the rest of the country gets to see the things that they might have missed.
So you've got six different acts each night? That's how it works?
I think.
Yeah, six different acts each night. One host and then five acts coming on and off, I think.
Yeah, and what sort of acts have we got?
We've got like Brendan Lovegrove, the Fan Brigade, Brendan Green, Angela Dravis from Jono and Ben, lots of different acts. And it depends where you are as well. Some of the acts in the North Island are different than the South Island, but all the details are on the Comedy Festival website.
Oh, check that out.
That was my marketing.
It's not the Comedy Festival, but it kind of is.
Yeah,
got it?
Sort of is.
And what was important about taking it to the rest of New Zealand? Were you just sick of Aucklanders getting everything good all the time?
Well, as an Aucklander, no. but, you know, you've got a bit of empathy.
Right.
So, And also, it'd be nice to travel, wouldn't it?
Yeah, it's nice to get a free trip. I'm from Christchurch, so it's nice to get a free trip home and to head home and, you know, not have to actually make the effort, have someone book my hotel and my flight. And by virtue of that, I get to see my family.
So what things are you taking it to? Where are you taking it? Lots of little ones.
There's like in the North Island, we're doing like Tauranga, we're doing like Whangarei, we're getting all over the place.
Do you think it's like people like comedy differently? This sounds really bad, that question. Do people like comedy differently in the smaller centres?
That does sound really bad.
I know, but you know what I mean? Is there different points of humour that
I'd
are say more popular?
So. I'd say so. I guess it's probably some of the smaller centres might not have seen much comedy before, so they wouldn't know what to expect.
You're saying I'm saying something bad? That's even worse.
Oh, well, I mean, seeing comedy like as like a live show coming to them because it doesn't go to them as well.
And they love it.
Oh, God.
No, they do. Okay, no, I'm still trying to get my head around it, though. Do you have a theme for the night? Or does every individual act, Eli, do their own routine?
It's just called the best comedy show of all time, so it's just us doing our best bits. We're each on stage for 15 or 20 minutes and we just talk about whatever we talk about.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay, cool.
So, Mel, if you...
I like it.
If you weren't in it, who would be your pick?
Oh, if I wasn't in it? Who's
Eli's
right here.
Who's your favourite child is?
But Eli's here, so definitely not him. I don't know. I think there's something for everyone.
Okay, who's your favourite up and comer at the moment?
Myself, of course. I think Angela Dravin. She's awesome. She's going to be on the show. She's going to be great.
Yeah, Ability Awards. She's awesome.
Speaking of that, doing stuff. What have you been up to since the Comedy Fest, Eli? Because I see you pop up quite a lot. You're very vocal on Twitter too, I've noticed.
Oh, thank you. I've got a lot to say.
He's always got something to say.
140 characters or less. I'm working full time at John and Ben for the rest of the year, pretty much. Doing this tour. Going to Australia at some point. Yeah, just
keep him busy.
What about you, Melanie? What are you doing after the tour?
I work full time at the project.
Everyone's basically working for TV3.
Basically, it's excellent stuff. Just I'm going to go to Australia too. It's going to be great. Just keep him busy.
Okay, and after this tour, what's next? Do we know? Obviously, you've got your jobs, but any other tours underway? Any other shows in the pipeline that we should know about?
Oh, yes, I'm bringing my comp. We both bring our comedy festival shows back. I'll speak. we both bring our comedy festival shows back by popular demand, and they're going to be at the basement, so get online.
Yeah, get online. They're also at comedyfestival.co.nz, my favourite website.
Seamless, Eli.
That's brilliant. Hey, guys, thank you so much for joining us today.
Nah, sounds great that you're taking it on the road. And
sounds
great
and
format.
Day asked us a big hole with the small centres. The small centres are the best, the backbone of New Zealand.
I never said they weren't. Oh, gosh.
The best comedy show on earth with Best Foods Mayo national tour kicks off in Whangarei this Wednesday. For all the details and for tickets, you can go to comedyfestival.co.nz.
Oh, seamless, Mel. Seamless.